Hey guys, welcome back to another video. This is Troy from Cichlid Bros. In today's video, we're doing a much requested topic, which is the top 10 tank mates for the Oscar Cichlid. We have done a care guide and a growth rate video on the Oscar, which you can find down in the description below. I figured we would round it all out with a tank mate video as well. Really excited to talk more about the Oscar, so let's dive right in. So the Oscar is no doubt one of the most popular fish in the hobby today, and for good reason. They have a great personality and awesome coloration, but they do get very large, and in some tank setups they could be aggressive, so it is a bit tricky when looking at tank mate options. So the Oscar is a South American cichlid, and it can grow over a foot in length, and it grows very fast as well. Because of this, there are two main caveats to the list before we get into the tank mate options for the Oscar. The first is just tank size. We would recommend keeping the Oscar in nothing smaller than a 75-gallon tank, and ideally you're keeping them in something much larger, like a 125 or even bigger. You're gonna have much more success keeping Oscar with any of these tank mates on the list if you have a tank size that is appropriate not only for the Oscar, but to keep them alongside different tank mates. The other part of this I would really recommend is just considering the size of the tank mates when you're adding them to the tank alongside the Oscar. For example, in my 180-gallon aquarium here, I have 7 Geophagus Tapajos, but because I had these for 2 years and they grew up to be about 5 to 6 inches in length before I added the Oscar, they are very compatible tank mates now because they are not too small for the Oscar to go after or even try to eat them. If I had added a 1-inch Oscar at the same time that I added 1-inch Geophagus Tapajos, I would have most definitely had issues and probably wound up with no Tapajos left in this tank, as the Oscar probably would have picked them all off. The reason for this is that the Oscar's growth rate is so fast, it's one of the fastest of any cichlid in the hobby today, which can really lead to issues if you stock your tank with small Oscars and other small tank mates. The growth rate just won't be the same, and the other fish will become targets once that Oscar reaches that foot in length. But as long as you're keeping tank size and the size of your tank mates when you're stocking the tank, this top 10 list should work in most cases, and I'm excited to get into it. So let's start with number 10 on the list. So number 10 on the list is one of my favorite all-time cichlids, and that is the Electric Blue Acara. The Electric Blue Acara is a South American cichlid, and as you can tell, it has a striking blue coloration. It's that pop of blue that you really don't get in many of your American cichlid tank setups. Electric Blue Acaras are very active swimmers, and they're very adaptable when it comes to tank parameters and tank mates. They can go with a lot of smaller tank mates, but they can hold their own against some larger fish like the Oscar. They also have very contrasting colors to your typical Oscar, so it's a great pop of different coloration in your tank setup. Electric Blue Acaras are usually not very aggressive, so you don't have to worry about them going after your Oscar at all. And as long as you add the Electric Blue Acara at a decent size, the Oscar usually won't go after the Electric Blue Acara as well. And because they're South American cichlids, they share a similar temperature, water parameters, and diet, so they work really well together. I recommend the Electric Blue Acara for a lot of different tank setups, and I definitely would in the right situation with an Oscar as well. So coming in at number 9 on the list, and this is one of the few that isn't from South America, and that is the clown loach. Clown loaches are awesome fish with a ton of great personality and color to them. Because they're usually kept in groups and they stay towards the bottom of the tank and they hide out some, they really stay out of the way of your Oscar most times. The clown loach does get pretty large as an adult, but they are a slow grower, so again, keep in mind when you're adding a small clown loach to the tank, it might take a while for them to reach their full size and maturity. And then coming in at number 8 is another fish from Asia, which is the Bala shark. I kept the clown loach and the Bala shark pretty low on the list just because they aren't from South America, so some purists may not like mixing the different continents, but overall the Bala shark and the clown loach are very adaptable to the tank parameters that you would keep with your Oscar. The Bala shark is a very active fish that gets pretty big and does resemble a shark to a certain degree, and just makes for a really awesome fish and a combination with an Oscar. I currently have 1 Bala shark in my tank with my Oscar here in the 180-gallon aquarium, but Bala sharks also do really well in a small school, so it could be a really cool option to go with a small school of Bala sharks in a tank with an Oscar. It could provide a lot of swimming activity throughout the mid and upper levels of your tank, But do keep in mind that boa sharks do get pretty large, so you'll definitely want a sizable tank. I know it's kind of bordering on the upper levels of a typical fish keeper of having just that large of a tank, but if you are getting up to the 220s or any other larger tank sizes, I think a small school of boa sharks alongside an Oscar would be a really cool tank setup and something to consider. So the final seven on this list can all be found in South America, similar to the Oscar. Coming in at number seven is the true parrot cichlid. So the true parrot is a very underrated cichlid. It has awesome coloration with some blues and greens with some really big red eyes. I had one in my 180 here for a while. It was a very peaceful, very gentle giant, and it got along great with my Oscar. And because it gets so large, it gets up to about a foot in length, sometimes even longer, it can work really well and hold its own against a big Oscar cichlid. If you have something like a 125 gallon tank, I could see an Oscar and a true parrot and maybe a school of something else working really well in that tank setup. They're South American cichlids, so they do best with some sand, rocks, driftwood, just a similar tank setup to what the Oscar would typically have. And the true parrot is not to be confused with the blood parrot, which I guess could work with the Oscar as well, but overall I prefer the true parrot, which is just an awesome fish. It could go really well in a South American cichlid tank setup, especially if it's more of a community to go along with your Oscar. Coming in at number six is another South American cichlid, and that is just the broader category of geophagus. Like I said, I have seven geophagus topos in my 180 with my Oscar right now. I have a Satanoparica gyropari, I have a geophagus steindagneri, and they all have done really well with the Oscar. Some of your larger geophagus, like a brasiliensis or a weinmilleri, could really work well with an Oscar over time, especially because they're larger. Geophagus are only number six on the list because you have to be very careful with when you add them to the tank in comparison to the Oscar. Geophagus are notoriously slow growers, so it might take a couple years for them to reach that 4 to 5 inch mark in some cases, which is really when I start feeling comfortable that an Oscar won't take a bite or eat them in general. So if you're going to add geophagus to a tank with an Oscar, just make sure they're already big or you allow them to grow out for a while before you add a smaller Oscar to that tank setup. But overall, geophagus are awesome cichlids with very unique behaviors. They will sift through the sand, churning over your substrate, making sure it's spotless and getting some of that uneaten food. They usually hang out in the bottom third of the aquarium as the Oscar swims around everywhere, so it makes for a really cool element to any type of South American community setup that you have alongside your Oscar. So number five on the list is another South American cichlid, and well, it's because it's another Oscar. So Oscars can work really well together as tank mates, and because there are different types of Oscars, it could be really cool to mix and match what you keep together. You could keep a tiger with a red and maybe an albino Oscar all in the same tank together. You can multiply that awesome size and personality you get from one Oscar by two or three or four, depending on your tank size and setup. Of course, if you're gonna keep more than one Oscar, your tank size requirement does go up pretty significantly. Again, the 75 gallon aquarium is the recommended minimum for one Oscar, and that's really pushing it already. So if you're gonna keep more than one Oscar, I would recommend a 6 foot tank or larger to really keep them in an appropriate setup. So overall, I would always recommend keeping an Oscar, so why not do more than one? Coming in at number four on the list are different plecos and catfish, especially the type that come from the same regions in South America. These fish a lot of times will scavenge the bottom of the tank, eat your algae depending on the type you go with, and they basically have an armored exterior which really protects them from an Oscar that's maybe getting a little too curious or going after them. They also stay in regions of the tank that will be out of the Oscar's way, so you don't have to worry too much about them occupying swimming space or the Oscar going after them in most situations. In some of the big ponds out there, you might be able to keep a massive adult Oscar with something like a red-tailed catfish or other types of catfish, although that does start getting us out of the region of the practical or typical fish keeper. But that combination could be really cool if you do have the means to set that up. But in a normal tank size, there are some really great options, especially for the plecos that could go with the Oscar. But overall, it's a very common type of fish to keep with an Oscar, and I've seen it work out most times. Number three on the list is another schooling fish that works very well with the Oscar, and that is the silver dollar. We recommend silver dollars for a lot of your mid-sized to even larger American cichlids because they provide a lot of activity in your tank, swimming back and forth constantly in that very cool schooling manner. They're big enough that they're not usually in danger of being a snack for any of the other cichlids in the tank, and they can act as dither fish, which makes the rest of the cichlids in your aquarium more comfortable in their environment, making them come out of hiding a little bit more. They are also endemic to South America, so they share the same water parameters as the Oscar, making them just overall a very good tank mate option. Number two on the list is another one of the most underrated cichlids in the hobby today, and that is the chocolate cichlid. Of course, our list of top 10 tank mates is very heavy in cichlids. We are the cichlid bros after all. But the chocolate cichlid works really well with a Oscar cichlid because they both reach a large size. The chocolate cichlid can get up to a foot, sometimes even a little bit longer, and they have a wide body, so they're sometimes equal in total size as the Oscar. They do have some complementary and contrasting colors to the Oscar cichlid, as they have some purples, some pinks, some greens. Overall, just a very unique looking fish. They are South American cichlids and they're semi-aggressive, but if you have an appropriate tank size, some of that aggression dissipates and they work really well with something like an Oscar. In my 180 gallon tank, I've had this chocolate cichlid with my Oscar for about 2 years now, and they've really coexisted, never having an issue whatsoever. My chocolate cichlid here is actually the same size, maybe even slightly bigger, than my tiger Oscar, and I really like having these two big cichlids in this community setup. And because they are South American cichlids, they share the same water parameters and tank setup requirements, making them a great option and number two on the list of tank mates for an Oscar. So if you've been following along with the channel for any length of time, you could probably guess what's number one on the list. And that is my favorite all-time cichlid, and that is the Severum. I could talk all day about the Severum, but just to keep this short and sweet, the Severum cichlid is a great tank mate option for the Oscar for a lot of reasons. They get pretty big and they grow pretty fast, so they keep up with the Oscar to a certain degree. They are usually gentle giants, so they won't go after your Oscar too much, but they can also hold their own in most cases if your Oscar is being aggressive to them. Again, they're from South America in the same general region, so a tank setup of sand, driftwood, rocks, maybe some fake plants. One other benefit for the Severum is that they come in a lot of different color patterns and variations. In this tank here, I have four Severums. I have a turquoise, a red shoulder, and red spotted gold Severums, and they all do really well together, so you could keep multiple Severums alongside your Oscar. And Severums won't be so big that you need a crazy big tank just to be able to keep them. If you have a 90 or a 125, something on the smaller end for keeping an Oscar, I would recommend keeping a Severum. Overall, just an awesome cichlid and one I probably won't stop talking about anytime soon, but that's why it comes in at number one. So lastly, I'm gonna quickly go through some honorable mentions. Starting with a few very large fish, that would include the arowana or stingray. Both can work really well, but sometimes they're tank busters and just require a very large tank that the average fish keeper may not have. So that's why they narrowly miss the list. And then you have some of your Central American cichlids like the Jack Dempsey, the Firemouth, and the Convict, which are all very common to be kept with an Oscar, but they are from Central America and they tend to be on the more aggressive end. I do think they can be kept with the Oscar, you just have to be careful. And then when you look at some of the South American cichlids I didn't mention, like the Green Terror or Gold Som or the Jaguar, a few of those can be just a little too aggressive for the Oscar, although I have seen it work in a lot of situations. I've also seen peacock bass and walru work with Oscars, so in some situations those could also be options for you. So that's the top 10 list of tank mates for an Oscar cichlid, along with some honorable mentions. If you've had any success keeping Oscars with a fish that's not on this list, make sure to leave that down in the comment section below. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time.